Hey, this is OXDF, and today we're looking at Admin of Code 2022, Day 11, Monkey in the Middle. And there's an incredibly complicated description here. I'm going to start going through it. I'm just going to talk you through it. So we're going to get a list. Our puzzle input is going to be a list of monkeys. So we'll get monkey 0 with a bunch of stuff, and then monkey 1 with a bunch of stuff, monkey 2 with a bunch of stuff, etc. And so we're going to do... what's called a round. And around, we're going to process each monkey. And so for each monkey, we're going to take the items they have. So in this case, like 79 and 98 for monkey 0. We're going to apply the operation. So if in this case, 79 times 19 will be the new value for, they call it a worry value. Then we're going to do an arbitrary divide by 3 and round down, because that's just part of the prompt. Then we're going to test, is it divisible by 23? If yes, this item of this new value goes to monkey 2, and if no, it goes to monkey 3. Then we can finish, we do the next, you know, now we'll do the same thing for 98, multiply by 19, divide by 3, test, and then throw, and then we'll go to the next monkey. We'll all do this monkey. Now, one of these items, right, this 79, is going to get thrown to monkey 2, for example. When I get to monkey 2 in this round, it'll already be there, so I, you know, the items can move around within a round. And so by the time I get to monkey 3, I'll probably have more than just 74 in its queue. But once I've processed all of monkey 3, so at the end of this round, monkey 3 will be empty, my round is over. I need to track how many times, let's see, where's my exact, so at the end of this round, blah, blah, blah. Like I said, there's a lot of stuff here. You have to count how many times, each time a monkey inspects an item, we increase its count for that. And then we got to look for the two highest monkeys in that regard. So, and we got to do 20 rounds. And so that's our challenge. We'll come over here and we will use our genday 11 and run this script. And that just pulls the input for me and creates a little stub. I had details in the first video. So one thing I want to look at right away with the input is some things like, so it looks like when we parse in starting items, that's fine. We'll just split on space. Or maybe we'll split on colon and then split on comma and apply int. I'm curious about my operation. Is it all, so we can do something like here where we do cat input.text into a grep on operation. In fact, we can see how many monkeys we have. Only 8 monkeys, not as bad as I had thought, but maybe they all have longer queues here. So we have 8 operations. Let's see if we... I guess we can just look at those then. So it looks like sum, we have multiplying, we have plus, we have one where it's actually squaring itself. So I have to be aware of that. That also means that number is going to grow pretty big. I guess maybe when we're dividing by 3, that'll help, but sum addition, that'll be pretty small. Okay, that's good to know. Let's also look at like the test. If I do a grep minus v divisible, nothing. So they're all divisible by. So all I have to do is really check and see, really get this last number, and that's my check. That's good to know. Okay, so that seems fine. Let's grab a monkey to bring over here. I really enjoyed yesterday doing this with classes and things, so we'll probably do that. We'll do a class monkey, and we will have, deft under init. Self goes to none. Look at that autofill. I like that. We're also, the monkey is going to take text, we'll call it. And even, I think we call this a string. Is it? Does that work? Ooh, nice. Look at our type ending. So, what are we going to do when we get a monkey? We're basically going to parse it into its parts. So, we'll do for line in string.split. New line. And now let's put our monkey here. Like that, basically. Okay, so first, our first line here will be self.id. Oh, we don't really need. We'll we'll not worry about the monkey number. We'll assume we put them in an order. So we can say self.items equals, I guess we can just use a list here. Just say this, we'll say lines. We don't, instead of looping, because we don't really need to loop, we'll say lines equals that. And then we can say self.items equals lines sub one dot split on colon dot split, that split on colon, and then we want minus one, the back half, the back a bit. And then we want to split on comma. And now we'll have an array. And for that, we want to turn them all into ints. So we can say map int onto that. And then we really need to turn that into a list. So we'll say list. Okay, that's probably good for the items. Operation. This is going to be interesting. What we can do here, it's going to be a pain because these aren't even all numbers. We can assume old is, this is tough. Let's see. So if we say dot split on equals. I will say these are all valid Python. So we could do something like, this might be ugly. What if we do what if we make a string like this? And that is a item like that. Split on equals, and we want to get minus one, the back bit. So now this will get us that. Now we could say lambda old of this. And what that's going to do is it's going to say, if we do a eval, which is really a not safe thing to do on unknown input, but we've looked at the input and we can be confident that's not going to screw, not going to exploit us here. So if we take this, what we've just done is we've said lambda old is equal to, in this case, old times three. So that's that we're actually going to create a function. This whole thing, when we eval it, is going to create a function. So we can call this like self.func, or I guess op equals that. And I think we just set that to a function that takes in an old and returns, in this case, old times three, but it'll also return old times old. So I think that'll actually work nicely. Now we need to do self.test equals lines sub three dot split. Let's just do space and we'll get the last thing. And then we will int that. And that's all we really need. And then we need the true and false. So we need self.true target equals int. Oops, not int. Well, let's see. Lines sub four dot split. Again, I think we can do our space here, minus one. And we got our last thing. And yeah, let's make that an int. That'd be nice. And then we can do the same thing here for false target and make this line sub five. So I think we just made ourselves a monkey. Let's see, we can test, let's come down here and we'll say f equals, we'll say this lines, we'll say, we'll call this monkey text equals f dot read dot split on double new line, because that'll give us kind of our monkey line, monkey array. I guess this is monkey texts. And so we could do something where we say like m equals monkey text sub zero and see if this works. See if you print m and see what happens. Python day 11 input.txt index out of range. All right, let's put minus m pdb minus cc. And what do we have here? So we have self.items. Let's see what lines we have. Nothing. Well, that's that explains. Oh, because it's not string. Text. Cue it out of this, run it again. All right, we can quit. That seemed to work. We just didn't print the monkey object well. Oh, let's run it here. We can say, do we have an M still? No. So let's, it may have worked now, but now instead of doing PDB, let's just do a dash I there. Now we can look at M. What do we want to see here? M.items. Oops. M.items. 53 info. That looks good. M.op is a function. Let's say if we have M.op of 3, we get 9. Sweet. So that worked well. M.test, not text. M.test is 2, divisible by 2. Good. Okay. M.true. What did I call it? True target equals 2, and that then false target equals 6. Okay, we seem to be parsing monkeys nicely, so I'm happy about that. Cool. Let's go up here. So we can now have a monkey class that works nicely. So now we're going to have a class, I don't know, let's call it world, def, init, like that, and we're going to pass in. Oh, actually, we can just, well, okay, yeah, we'll pass in monkey texts. And we are going to then, we'll say monkeys equals an empty list. Oops, we'll say self.monkeys equals an empty list. And we can say for empty in monkey text, because we already divided it down here into individual things. We can say self.monkeys.append monkey empty. And if we do this, we should have a world with a bunch of monkeys in it, where we have them all parsed. And so we can now say like world equals world of monkey texts. We don't need to do that. Let's run this again and see how that looks. And so if we do world, if we do world dot monkeys, we've got a bunch of monkeys there. So if we do world dot monkeys, the last one, we can look at like it's, see, so we just double check here. It should be, if we do world dot op of 6, we should get 11. We do. If we do dot test, we should see 19. Nice. Okay. So this is looking nice. So we now have a world in there. So now we gotta think what we wanna do. So we wanna define a round, right? So we'll come here and we'll say def round self. And then start with ourself, we're gonna take this and we're going to run around. So we're gonna say for m in monkeys, in self.monkeys. We're going to, for each monkey, let's review our, we're going to do for item in m dot items for each monkey, for each item. We're going to now look at the, let's see, where is my, let's grab the, oh, we got to add a count to our monkeys as well. So let's go up here. So monkey inspects the item. It first is going to do its op. Okay, so we're going to say val equals item equals m dot op item, like that. Let's go up here real quick and add this. So we need self.count or num items equals 0. We'll initialize that to 0. All right. So we're going to, right away, we can say m dot num, let's call it num items. Yep. Items plus equals 1. We're going to apply the op to the item to get the new val. And then we're going to get bored with it and divide by 3. We can do that right here. Divide by 3. Let's do it. Actually, let's do another line. Just val divide by equal. I don't know if that works. Val equals val divided by 3. Then we're gonna do our test. So we'll do if val, and when we divide something and we check and see if it's evenly dividing, we're just gonna check if its mod is equal to 0. So we'll say val mod m dot test equals 0. So that means it does divide. Self dot monkeys sub m dot true, what did I call it? True what? Target. Target. And because my monkeys start at 0 and they're in and they go, you know, when I throw to monkey 2, it's going to be the second monkey in our list, so that's good. Self dot true target dot items dot append val. Else self dot monkeys m dot false target dot items dot append val. And after we go through all the items, m dot items, it's going to be this because it's going to have thrown them all away. So really, I mean, if we want to be gutsy here, we can come here and we can say world.round. Let's just run that once and see how it works. It runs quickly. That's nice. So we could do, we want to do 20 rounds for underscore in range 20 world.round. It runs quickly. That's good. The last thing we really want to get out of the world is let's get our, like, get score, I guess. We can make a function for that. Def get score self. How do we get the top two? Self.monkeys. We'll do sorted. Comma key equals lambda. Now we're going to get a monkey, right? So we'll call it M. And we're going to sort by the count. So we'll do m.count. No, it wasn't called count. We called it, what do we call it? Num items. Num items. And let's just, actually, let's return that right now. So we can call get world.getScore and see what we get back. Let's save this. Let's run this. If we call world.getScore, we get back a list of monkeys. So we can do m for m in world.getScore, and we can do m.numItems, and we get back that. Sweet. Let's actually put this as a negative. That way it will give me a reverse order. So if we do that again, now we get the highest ones first. And so now we can just multiply the first two together to get our score. So we're going to do that. We'll say sorted monkeys equals that. And then we can say return sorted monkeys sub 0 times sorted monkeys sub 1. And we get back, we can just say world.getScore after 20 rounds. So we might have an answer here. Let's see how we have to, I'm going to be shocked if we don't have to do some troubleshooting here, but let's give it a try. Oh, we don't have that. Dot num items. Dot num items. Because we're not multiplying monkeys, we're multiplying values. Let's give it a try. I'll be amazed if this works, but sometimes it does. We did. Got it. Awesome. Okay. Part two. You're worried that you might not ever get your items back. So you're so worried, in fact, that you're relieved that you... I'm going to read and then speed the video up to catch up to where I am. Okay. So we're going to do the same thing again. I believe we're starting from scratch, but this time there's a couple differences. One, we don't get divided by 3. So we're gonna have to update our world class to sort of take like a part one and part two. We'll make a new world basically. And in this second world, we don't divide by three. It says you're gonna need to find another way to keep your worry levels manageable. And that's a huge hint. We're gonna need that. We're also gonna go for 10,000 rounds instead of 20. But otherwise it's exactly the same. So we're gonna need a little math here, I'm sure. Let's start here. First of all, let's come in here and update our world. So world will now take self monkey text and part two equals false. So if we call it without anything, it'll just make it normal. And then we can say here, if not part two, do that. So now we have, we've updated that. So we no longer do that. So when we call our world down here, we're still running part one. We also should do, oh no, that's fine. Cause we do our rounds down here, right? Okay. So if I think, let's see. So if we do world two equals world monkey texts and part two equals true. And then we do for in range, let's just do 20 for a second. World two dot round. Okay, we're not going to need a part two here. And we are going to say world two dot get score. So if we try this, this is not going to be the right answer. It's just going to be the part two. Part two is not defined. Let's see if not part two. Oh, we should do self dot part two equals part two. And then here we should be doing self.part two. Okay, try that again. Okay, so we got something, right? But if we try to go down here and make this 10,000, I'm thinking it's gonna hang. But let's try it, because we may have done it. Yeah, it's gonna hang. It's gonna run for a long time. And the reason is, when we were dividing by three earlier, we were keeping the numbers pretty low. If we remember, we have the one that was like old times old. So it's going to like raising something to the power itself 10,000 times is a lot, and it's going to get huge. So we're going to have to take advantage of some idea here. And that is that we're only checking to see if the number is divisible by something. And basically that means we're using it, doing modular arithmetic. And the cool thing is, if something is divisible by six, for example, then that number mod six. So like, let's think of a number. 18 is divisible by 6. 18 mod 6 is also divisible by 6, because we'll check, you know, what is 18 mod 6? Well, it's 0. And then we'll 0 is divisible by 6, so we're good. The cool thing is, if we're curious to know if something's divisible, if we're going to only need to know if it's divisible by 6 and by 7, we can work out of mod 42, which is 6 times 7, and we'll still be good. And there's math I could show you to define this, but really what we need to find is the lowest common denominator, the lowest common multiple of all of the tests we want to do. And what we can do is actually keep our worry level low by working out of that mod. A less efficient way would just be to multiply all of them together. And that's what I'm actually going to do. So we're going to say like self.mod factor equals, and we're going to do M for M in self.monkeys, and we'll do M.test. And then how do you do a product in, that is a good question. We'll have to do some, let's Google real quick. Python product of list. Multiply all the numbers in a list. Let's see how to do this. All right. I don't want to make my own function. I guess I could make my own function. I don't really want to use NumPy. For some reason, I've always resisted NumPy. Func tools reduce. Man, I guess the answer is there's not a great answer. Maybe we'll go with func tools reduce. Oh, import math, math.prod. Okay, that's our answer. And then part of our world will be, where were they setting this? Here we go. Math.prod. We don't even need to make, we can make this a generator instead, and that should look good. Okay, so now down here, what we can do is instead of, we can do this in part one too, actually, it won't affect us. We can say else val equals val mod, not mod, mod self dot mod vector. And that'll keep our val number low. And if it works, it might give us an answer quickly. It did give us an answer quickly. Let's see if it's the right answer. Yes. All right. So effectively what we did was, let's actually, I'll show you. I can show you why this is necessary. Let's comment this out for a second. And we will come here and print val. And just watch the val numbers go as we run this. And you can see how huge they're getting. I controlled C that there, but like we weren't. These numbers are filling my screen. They're unreasonably large. And those are the numbers when then when I'm checking, when I'm having to do the division with them and do operations with them, it's going to get slow real quick. Let's do that same thing where I don't where I keep the mod. And the mod's not a small number, right? Like we're still, it's going to be, thousands, right? But like, see, now we're running things where where all the things fit on one line, so we can operate in reasonable time. So, that was a really neat challenge. I had a lot of fun. I'm enjoying. It's probably not if we're trying to do competitive, like how do I rank in the top 100, go as fast as I can, making these classes and wouldn't necessarily be the right way to go. But to me, it's a nice way to lay out what we're doing and try to map that. So, I don't know. Hopefully, you found that interesting. Thanks for hanging out with me today, and I will be back tomorrow. Thank you.